Oh, J.D. Salinger. J.D. Salinger. J.D. Salinger. I like your book, Catching the Rye. J.D. Salinger, you are an interesting guy. You were like, I can't take this anymore. I'm just gonna go hide in a little town in New Hampshire with some lady. And when I do that, everybody is gonna wonder what I'm doing, and it will cement my legacy. Everybody loves a good recluse. Everybody loves to wonder what's going on in the house of the recluse, and everybody wants to come in. And lots of people go to Cornish, New Hampshire, and they're like, hey, where does J.D. Salinger live? And all the people who live in Cornish, New Hampshire are like, get out of here, give poor J.D. his privacy. Oh, yeah. Oh, 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 yeah. Oh, yeah. J.D. Salinger. Yeah. I'm so sad that you are dead. I like to imagine you still being alive, living in some house in Cornish, New Hampshire, and writing all kinds of novels and just leaving them in boxes for the world to dig out when you're gone, because you don't want to have to deal with all those crazy people out there. All those people, everybody loves a recluse. Yes, they do. Especially if it's a literary recluse. Oh, 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 oh. If it's some kind of guy who used to be a ticket taker at the movie theater who decided to shun the outside world, I don't believe he would be as celebrated as J.D. Salinger. You know what I'm saying? I mean, think about it. Think if some guy was a ticket taker and really good at it for many years, but then he just said, I've had enough, and he moved to a little New Hampshire town. Oh, oh. I don't think people would be making pilgrimage to that little town to try to meet the ticket taker. But I think I'm losing focus. Think I'm losing focus.